you know, that building that esport field and building that audience, right? So with H1Z1, we took an approach, for better or for worse, do not recommend this for the lighthearted. We went into early access, right? And so we, like you said, we've been developing the game alongside people for our community for a long time. And that's great, right? And that is what led us here, you know, to TwitchCon 2016 with our invitational again, the popularity that King of the Kill is seeing. It is because we were able to watch the effect that Twitch had on the game and those communities of those streamers. You could see that the game was just as fun to watch as it was to play. That's not true of every game that goes out there. And, you know, a lot of times, you know, people go and they watch their favorite streamer, and they're watching because it's their favorite streamer, right? They want to be with that person. And then there are the games that they like watching the game too. They might not even care about the streamer necessarily. They love watching the game. They want to see the competitive play. And so to use it to find your audience and see if you have something, like as a test, right? Is this going to be something that people want to watch? Can we fill auditoriums with people to you know, and generate the kind of prize pools and interest that we want? Because I've seen games go out there trying to manufacture, you know, their title as an esport, and it just doesn't work, right? And it's because you have to find that audience, and you have to figure out what decisions you're making to have a broadcast-friendly game. That's very important. If for the streamer too, right? Your game's so complex, they can't focus on being entertaining and, you know, managing their chat and getting in touch with their community while also being good at the game. That's kind of a problem too.
Yeah, well,
it's got